Peter O'Fader here tonight.
Hello.
Welcome to Holland.
Welcome again.
Fader is one of the most extreme bands on this festival tonight. Did you adapt your playlist because this is more heavy metal orientated festival today?
You know, actually, I don't know about the orientation of this festival in any other, which we did take a part or like we will. We just play what we do, and the people like it or not, usually like. So it's always good to play in Holland. Oh, it's a heavy metal festival, death metal festival, black metal, whatever. It's metal. So yeah. I'm pretty much sure that people will like it.
Hey, well, what's your opinion about this festival so far?
You know, we arrived pretty early, but the weather is not really nice. But you know, it's not about weather; it's about the atmosphere inside of a tent. You know, and it's became already pretty heavy. Mm-hmm. You know, so yeah. I expect a good show tonight. This is actually we're starting a season tonight, so this is like a special one, special show. We took a flight for. So tomorrow we're coming back to finish the album, all these mixing things, and actually we're starting the touring in June.
How are the Dutch metal fans compared to other countries?
It's hard to say it's metal. You know, Dutch fans, like European fans, like pretty much into metal because, like, which I can say, the heavy metal came from here, even if it's a big influence of American scene and the metal music, especially in such extreme kind of metal we play. Mm-hmm. But metal is still European, I pretty much believe in that, and I am very European, so to play in Holland, it's always a big pleasure.
Fader were pioneers for the Polish death metal scene back in the 80s. How was the scene in Poland back then, when you guys started the band?
It's hard to say about the scene back then because, like, we were among those who were starting this underground and extreme scene. Because, of course, like, we are not a first band who started to play heavy metal in Poland. Of course, we had Turbo, we had Cat, we had like TSA, the bands, but they were more into a real like, a classical heavy metal, pretty much influenced by the AC/DC and the Iron Maiden and things like that. Mm-hmm. And us and several other bands. Unfortunately, not too many of them survived the time. There are just a few guys I still know, so we can talk about the old days. And a few of them just started to do a band again after years, like Christ Agony, for example. Mm-hmm. So we started something in the 80s, which was like not easy, because that was different country, different government, and actually nobody cared about the music, but there was no places, no magazines, no nothing which could support heavy metal at all. Mm-hmm. So we just started it. Magazine, the xerocopied zines, just shows, the little shows we made with friends. Like we invited the other bands to play in our city, so they did the same with us. So we started something.
Mm. But with the intention to break through international because Poland didn't have a good scene?
That could be only a dream. Because nobody was dreaming about like playing outside of Poland at all. That was like not possible to have even a passport. That was not easy, you know. So our system tried to cap people in Poland and this communist bloc to show them that this is the best which can happen for you in your life. West is poisoned, it's not good. So that was the good thing, like to keep people deaf for what's happening in the West, you know, in the real world, let's say.
Yeah.
But you know, then the time started to change in the 80s in Poland and in Europe, and after this Berlin Wall fell down, so then we started to do something in the West as well. We started to record the songs in English. That was like international, it was the only chance to break through. And you know, spread out the tapes around the world, and everything actually started in, I was 88, 89, let's say, in the real.
And did you guys had a lot of trouble with the Catholic Church in Poland back then?
That came later, actually. No, church was not in power those days. That was more like tradition, still is, but now this is pretty much political power, not even church like a church, the people who call themselves like a pretty much influenced, very Catholic, and they just like to make a mess sometimes, you know, in the country. You know, like doing bad things for young people's minds, and so
But how?
We just a band who tried to be against, like, not against like belief, just against this political system called the church. You know?
But in what way? Did they protest against concerts that you guys did or something like that?
You know, they know that they cannot do that because, like, democracy means that you can, until you're not like doing anything wrong against, we're not like forcing people to do bad things, you know. But they can always like fight against the music with canceling the shows, calling like, for example, like a fire department to make them telling the promoter just this building is not ready for making the shows, which is not a problem to do like other shows like a week later, let's say. You know? So that's kind of tricks, you know, used pretty often by those people. But actually, like, we can say, like, we had real problems, you know. We survived that, we still have shows in Poland, it's not as many of them compared to the rest of the world, but we're still trying to arrange, like, a tour, at least one once a year, so can't complain.
No. Was it hard back those days to get some international attention for your band?
Pretty much. Actually, we had some friends connected with like US or Western Europe, who had families and had, of course, like a source in vinyls, like tapes, magazines, merchandise. And those guys, those friends were like a source for us. So we traveled across the land, across the country, just to copy some tapes, you know, to take some pictures, just spend good time drinking beer, like spending time listening to music, you know. Mm-hmm. So that was the only way. You know, there was no stores, no nothing, no internet, you know. There was like, you could just write a letter, send it, or just to travel by train, you know, and meet people, meet friends. The good days, actually, you know. It's like, it's something which I miss today. It's like people, today, which I never understood that, like they really like to stay in home and contact by like these communicators and then to go and meet face by face and spend good time.
Yeah.
Good.
Not a good
times
development.
Times changed.
Yeah, times changed, definitely. But do you still get a lot of credit for your pioneering work with Vader in Poland nowadays?
You know, it was a big help, not just for us, that was for the followers. You know, the many bands just found this hole in the wall, and they kept following us in the West, so now there's like way more band from Poland are pretty much known in outside of our country. But we are like pioneers, like a forepost, you know, for all this scene, and this is good. I think it's that was not just luck. Of course, luck was like a big factor in that, but after we signed a deal with Earache, which was like pretty big label company, pretty known those days, and the first big tour with Bolt Thrower,
by the way.
And then with Deicide and Suffocation in the US, that was like a real big chance for us, and of course, like, we made it happen, you know, for us. So the people started to know us, even not those who knew us before from tapes, those who never saw us before, and they just because we supported good bands that we had a chance to show up for really good crowd, you know? Everything started those days.
But not that Polish bands still kind of see you as guys as like, whoa, Vader, those were...
I had a feeling that it was like that. For many people, it was like, wow, it's like an exotic band from like behind the wall, you know? They changed mind pretty fast because like became like we came of course from Poland, from behind a wall, but we same guys, you know, just our roots were from different place. Mm-hmm. But the feelings, you know, dreams still the same, you know.
Yeah. Same interest in metal.
I think we could say the same about, let's say, Sepultura and their career when started, remember. So that was the same story. When they started, they were like from Brazil. It's like kind of interesting, but they pretty fast became like a very, very popular band. So.
But is the Polish underground scene still seeing you guys as, whoa, those are the guys from Vader who were the first metal band from Poland that really made it?
Yes, there is kind of respect for that. There's kind of respect for that. But, you know, I think we work pretty strong for like to be not just the guys who try to use the old days to be famous, you know. So we're just a band who like to play music, metal, especially live on stage. So that's why like we still have the new guys, new fans coming up every year. So there's still like 40, 50 years old friends like among the crowd, but we see like many young kids, really young, like.
And that's good.
So this is good, you know, because it means like the music is not just for one season. Yeah, that's probably the biggest success of a band. You know? Yeah.